Magma formed by melting of the mantle at the edge of the hotspot rises from the base of the plate through cracks and fissures. Erupted lava is quenched by cold water, forming pillar basalts. As the plate carries the volcano directly over the hotspot, the chemistry of the lava changes to less viscous lava than the previous more alkali-rich phase. The volcano builds with repeated cycles of construction and collapse. Lava-water interaction results in explosive bursts of pyroclastic material impressive at the surface. It is interbedded with pillar basalt until lava can flow above the surface. Dense lava flows perch on this moderately unstable pile. Large landslides are common. High eruption rates increase over the center of the hotspot. Over hundreds of thousands of years, countless thin lava flows result in a broad, gentle sloping shield. The volcanoes are characterized by having large, shallow magma reservoirs that erupt frequently. Summit calderas alternately fill and collapse many times in the life of a shield volcano. As the volcano moves from the center of the hotspot, eruptions decrease and the summit magma chamber solidifies. After a non-eruptive time gap, renewed eruptions of more viscous alkali basalt produce the steep, hummocky cap on some, but not all, shield volcanoes. These eruptions are short-lived and form clusters of steep-sided cinder cones. With eruptions waning, erosion becomes the chief force shaping the land surface. Large gullies form as erosion outpaces lava production, and steep coastal cliffs develop as the island begins to shrink due to erosion and subsidence. Coral reefs grow in the shallow water around the flanks. Hundreds of thousands of years and several hundred kilometers from the hotspot, lava that was stored deep beneath the volcano rises to erupt, a last burst of lava. This lava is higher in alkalis than all previous eruptions. Eventually, continued erosion plus the increasing weight of the cooling seafloor result in the creation of extensive reefs atop the atoll. As the island moves further from the buoyant effects of the hotspot, it continues to sink, pulling the coral reefs too deep for corals to grow.